Mark, a solid performance from your side, and you'll be more than pleased that the endeavour has been rewarded in the second half.
Yeah, I thought it was a good game, actually. A really tough game. I think they've got a very good style. I think when we played Ben's team, Swindon, last year in the Cup, we saw the style in which they play with, and he's implemented that Charlton very well. And they caused us some problems in the first half. I thought the game began exactly as we thought it would. We created a couple of very good chances early on and could have perhaps gone in front in the game. And then the sucker punch comes late in the half, just before half time, when we concede. But we had to defend long periods in the first half. One, because we probably didn't sustain our own attacks or maintain possession well enough. And secondly, the importance of the first goal is big. But we came back from that. I thought in the second half we stepped on even more and actually became a bit more dominant and progressive with the ball. And I thought we were a better team in the second half, and perhaps might have been able to carve open a chance to take the win. However, you always know at the end of the game it's going to end up like that, and we had to defend our box brilliantly. So we did that a number of times, but they made subs, they were a bit more direct in the end of the game. This place gets going, and you know it's a tough last few minutes, and then 6 minutes goes up and that feels like an age. So we're delighted to take a point, and probably on the balance of the game, I think it's fair.
You're probably frustrated at half-time, as was the case on Tuesday, really, where you know everything seems to be going to plan, and the goal from Charlton came out of the blue to an extent, and I guess frustrating because there were chances at the other end, as you've said.
Yeah, I mean, their goal's probably a consequence of just pressure, enough hasn't to defend diagonals and crosses quite often, but I thought we defended our box well. I haven't seen the goal back, but in my mind, it was one of the easier crossing moments we had to defend and didn't do it very well. So it's a killer when that goes in, and that can make you lose heart quite a bit. But I am actually really encouraged by the response of the players from going behind late, you know, in the half this time. And Tuesday, I thought we came out and started the second half really well as well. So there's a bounce back ability there, a resilience there that we've got, which we need. The frustrating thing in the first half is I think we had the chances to take the lead, and we have to be more clinical in these games, because if we are, we can take a little bit more control. A counter-attacking game becomes a little bit easier to play rather than trying to chase the game. We have to try and dominate the game a little bit more in the second half. So good and bad in our first half. I thought some of our play was very good, but we needed to be better in possession, and certainly need to be a little bit more creative from the chances that we had. But I actually felt in the first half, in terms of a counter-attacking game, we had enough moments to create chances and enough chances to perhaps work the goalkeeper and end up in a better position than one down.
Yeah, the goal when it came, I think well deserved off the back of some decent pressure. Well worked goal as well. Charlo Tracy in Boulder thought we had a super game this afternoon. Harvey, he's adding goals to his game, isn't he?
Yeah, well, he needs to. That's an important part of his game in there. You know, he's a major part of his game for us is his out of possession work. I think he's an excellent transition player and an out of possession player, but I think that's the side of his game that we want to keep improving. We want to see goals and attacking threat from that position as well. He almost plays two positions for us, and that's a tough demand, but he can do that physically. I thought the wide players played well as well. Really, really tricky game for them, but certainly I thought Shiloh started the game on fire, was a real threat, and Roth got better as the game went on in the second half. I thought he was very good, and the goal was a really well worked goal. We had good ball in the second half. I thought we created some good chances. We got into crossing positions quite well today. Dunks delivers a really good ball, and it was a good move, and happy for Nibsy to get his goal.
You mentioned towards the end of the game, obviously, a bit of pressure from Charlton, and it was that collective defending, that will to get the point, and you must love seeing that on the touchline.
Yeah, of course. I mean, it would have been a sucker punch, really, because for the balance of the second half, they probably hadn't earned it, but they finished really strongly. And I thought that when they brought Leeburn on, when they brought Blackett-Taylor on, and then it ended, and Payne as well, and, you know, there's some real power and pace and attacking quality in there, which is going to cause you a problem. And we weren't able to dominate as much as we wanted to. You know, we made the change to put Sam out on the wide position and take Shiloh off, bring Joey on, because we wanted someone to secure the ball. We felt we had momentum of the game at that point, and I thought we could deliver some crosses and try and score a winning goal. And it so happened that they shifted the game the other way, really, and we had to defend for our lives a little bit. I think Lloyd makes an unbelievable challenge at the end, and a few throw their bodies in and block things. But, you know, that's what we are. And I think we sit after five games, and I think five really tough games to have taken 7 points from. I think that's really good for us.
Yeah, came out in a 4-3-3 formation, so same personnel. as the game against Oxford, which went well until very late on in the game. But what was the kind of science behind the slight tweak in formation?
Well, it only looked like that because they made it look like that, being honest, because they move the ball so well. They get into some excellent positions. Their rotation into wide areas is outstanding, and they make the pitch ginormous. And when you think you've got them, they switch it 80 yards from one side to the other. So it's very, very difficult to actually get in a solid and structured shape. And actually, in the moments, there's Nibsy's trying to press two or three different players, and the wide players are not sure when to jump, and your fullbacks can't engage because their wide players stay so high and wide, and Stockley drops really deep into midfield. I mean, it's fascinating, really. It's been fascinating watching it in the build-up to the game, and I thought they executed their game well. And for the majority part, we have to not get frustrated that's hard to contain sometimes, and it's hard to dominate sometimes. But therefore, we have to be incredibly clinical when we are attacking, and secondly, we have to defend our box brilliantly. And in the main, we did that okay, but we're delighted to come out with a point, but it's certainly a really good game for us to take some lessons from, because we'll play against many other good sides like that.
It's a difficult week, obviously, the long journey on Tuesday to come out with it with a defeat, a really challenging journey home for everyone. Obviously makes the weekend or the week a little bit tricky, but off the back of that, to come here and get the point, you must be chuffed to bits.
Yeah, and I thought physically we stood up well as well. You know, we made the changes Tuesday with a three-game week in mind. To have taken 4 points from the three games that we've had, Exeter, Portsmouth and here today, I think it's a good return for us at this stage of the season. And we want to try and get to the end of this really busy spell, hopefully progressing in cup competitions and getting off to a good start in the Papa John's, and hopefully with everybody fit and available going into September. So it's a good start for this point, but we've got plenty more games to come, and a really good one to look forward to on Tuesday night.
Thanks, Mark.
Pleasure.